to my house. Morning comes and you know that you wanna stay. Close the blinds, let's pretend that the time has changed. Keep our clothes on the floor, open up champagne. Let's continue tonight, come on, celebrate.
That's how we do.
Sometimes you gotta stay, and you know where I live. Yeah, you know what we is. Sometimes you gotta stay, welcome to my house. Baby, take control now. We can't even slow down. We don't have to go no while. Welcome to my house. Play that music too loud. Show me what you do now. We don't have to go no while. Welcome to my house. Welcome to my house.
Duck off the crib, the spot, the pad. But my house is your house if you're throwing it back. Excuse me if my home draining is sad. Soon as these happy faces land, you can run with the cash. Home run, slam dunk, touchdown pass. Mi casa es tu casa, so it ain't no holding back. Another shot of vodka, you know what's in my glass. It's my house, just relax.
Welcome to my house. Baby, take control now. We can't even slow down.
Tell you all my secrets, and you tell all your friends. Hold on to your opinions and stand by what you say. In the end, it's my decision, so it's my fault when it ends.
I lay out all my reasons. You'll say that I need help. We all got expectations, and sometimes they go wrong. But no one listens to me, so I put it in this song. They tell me think with my head, not that thing in my chest. They got their heads at my neck this time. But you're the one that I want. If that's really so wrong,
say no, 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 no all tied up, no more love, and I'd hate to see you waiting. Had to have high, high hopes for a living, shooting for the stars, but I couldn't make a killing. Didn't have a time, but I always had a vision, always had high, high hopes. Had to have high, high hopes for a living, didn't know how, but I always had a feeling I was gonna be that one in a million. Always had high, high hopes. Mama,
Good afternoon. No. Good afternoon. Much better. I'm Dr. G. Duncan Harris, the CEO of Capital Community College, and I'd like to welcome everyone to the 75th commencement exercises of Capital Community College. Will all please rise for the singing of the national anthem by Capital alum Renata Rodriguez. You are asked to remain standing following the anthem for an invocation by Reverend Terry Cummings of the Unitarian Society of Hartford.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Well done.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, everybody, and congratulations to the graduating class of 2022 of Capital Community College. My name is Reverend Terry Cummings. I am a Unitarian Universalist minister. It is a huge pleasure, privilege, and joy for me to lead you in prayer as we open this graduation ceremony. I feel so humbled to be in the presence of this group of talented students and their teachers, administrators, all of those family members who've supported you on your journey here today. I mentioned that I'm a Unitarian Universalist minister. It's okay if you've never heard of that faith tradition, but I will share one part of it with you, that we affirm and promote the inherent worth and dignity of every single human being, regardless of color or race or religious belief. And I invite you to imagine a mosaic made of tiles, where each tile represents an individual human being. And I'm looking out now, and I see a mosaic of tiles that present a beautiful picture of diversity. It is so wonderful to be here with you and see that picture in all of its grace and all of its glory. Thank you. We do not all share the same religious beliefs or traditions, but we, you and I, all share one important ingredient of life. That is love. Love for each other, love for ourselves, and love for community. And so I'm going to invite you now to join me in a moment of prayer or meditation. I ask you to feel your feet planted firmly on the ground. Feel the earth beneath you. Take a moment and breathe deeply. In my faith tradition, we have a tune that goes like this. I'll sing it for you. Maybe you may want to join me. When I breathe in peace. When I breathe out, I breathe out love. Can you share that with me one more time through? When I breathe in peace. When I breathe out love. And welcoming your breath into your bodies, feeling your breath. Notice also your beautiful hearts, your hearts that help you touch not just love, but the holy. Your hearts that are filled with care, compassion, courage, and joy, and gratitude. Will you pray with me now? I invite you into a moment of prayer. Spirit of life and love that is in each and every single one of us and which flows between us. God of many names and none, we offer up this prayer of gratitude for the Capital Community College graduating class of 2022. Holy One, we ask that you bless and guide these graduates as they chart new beginnings. May what they have learned allow them to make the world a better place, to serve others in true solidarity and kinship, to seek ways to help the poor, the marginalized, and those who are suffering, and to always seek the greater good. Holy One, with gratitude, we pray for their families and the many who have sacrificed and worked to see them to this hopeful moment. In gratitude, we pray for the teachers and administrators who have challenged, cared, and crafted them along this academic journey. And in gratitude, we pray for the other students who have taught them about friendship, scholarship, collaboration. Great Spirit, we give thanks for the community they have helped to build while they were here, and we hope and pray that although they are leaving, they will know to come back to this sacred space. Almighty God, today we also pray for tomorrow. This graduation opens up another door to another time. This graduation class will lead us all into the future. May they have focus and clarity, grace and courage, generosity and compassion, and above all, may you all experience love in your lives. Amen. Ashe, may it be so. Blessed be.
You may be seated. Distinguished guests, faculty, staff, the spirits and ancestors of the Wangunk peoples, upon whose native land we now gather, and the reason we are all here this afternoon, Capital Community College graduates of the class of 2022. It is indeed an honor for me to preside over our commencement activities and present 275 degrees and certificates to our graduates. This has been a 26 months like no other. Our country faced two pandemics, the COVID pandemic, which resulted in the loss of over 1 million Americans. This time last year when we had commencement, it was at 500,000. The second pandemic is tied to social unrest, injustice, and violence. Over the past 26 months, we had the murder of George Floyd and Breonna Taylor and others, the events of January 6th, the war in Ukraine, and the horror in Buffalo and in Uvalde that resulted in the senseless loss of so many lives. I have and will continue to pray for our faculty, staff, students, our country, and our world. Capital Community College has worked hard over the past two years to maintain our ability to ensure students learn and move toward their career and academic goals in spite of the pandemic. Thus, today's most sacred ritual, commencement. Be mindful that graduation, this hour and a half ceremony, is the capstone. This is a representation of all of the hard work you put into your classes and the assessment of our faculty. I, like many of you, am glad that we're able to do it safely and in person. This is our second time at Yard Goats Stadium, and we'd like to thank them for opening their doors to us once again for this most special occasion. Tim and crew, you guys are the best, and we're just so glad to have you as our neighbor. We're also live streaming this event on YouTube for those that may not have been able to be here today in person. My task this afternoon is, as my beautiful wife Garcia says, make sure you let her know that I said she was a beautiful wife, is to keep it moving. Our friends at Dunkin' Donuts Stadium and the Yard Goats have graciously rolled out their blue and green carpet, but we need to be out of here by about 3 or 3:30, so we're gonna keep it moving. With that, I'd like to introduce the members of our platform party, and we'll begin our program. Would they please stand as I call their names? Dean Jose Colon, who's the Associate Dean of Campus Operations. Elise Wright, Regent, CSCU Board. Erica Schultz Vandrella, who is our class valedictorian. Doctor, let me say that again, Dr. Jason Scappaticci, Associate Dean of Students. Jacqueline Santiago Nazario, who is our commencement speaker and CEO of Campus Youth Collaborative. Dr. Robert Steinmetz, who is the Capital East Regional President. Reverend Terry Cummings, Unitarian Society of Hartford. David McCluskey, who is the chair of the CCC Foundation. Denora Lopez, who is a Capital alum and the incoming chair of our CCC Foundation. And Dr. Debbie Mather, Professor of Medical Assisting and Allied Health and Professional Careers. This point, I'd like to introduce a few folks that could not be here in person, but recognize the significance of the day and the accomplishment of our graduates, and who have sent video messages of congratulations. Our CSCU President, Terrence Chang, and Matt Flory, the Chair of the Board of Regents. Following them, we'll hear greetings from Capital East Regional President, Dr. Robert Steinmetz.
Hello, I'm Terrence Chang, and I'm honored to serve as president of the Connecticut State Colleges and Universities System. On behalf of CSCU and the Board of Regents for Higher Education, I want to offer my sincere congratulations to all of this year's graduates. Ever since I joined the faculty back in 2003, graduation has always been my favorite day of the year because we get to unabashedly celebrate the success of our students. We get to say thank you to the faculty and staff who have helped us and worked with us all this time. We get to say thanks to the family and friends who have supported us along the way, because you can't do it alone. There is so much to feel good about, and every single one of you should be happy and proud of your achievements. I'm also thrilled that after more than 2 years of virtual meetings, masking, and social distancing, you were able to be together today in person. So today marks a significant milestone in your educational and personal journey. In many ways, your studies have been marked by disruption at school, at home, and in your personal lives. Yet thanks to your tenacity, commitment, focus, and dedication, you did not allow life to be defined by disruption. Instead, you recognized how the world had changed. You adjusted, you persisted, you grew stronger. You put in the hard work necessary to complete your degree and get it done. You have shown that it is today's students and graduates that are the change agents for the future and the next generation of leaders for the state of Connecticut and the nation. As graduates, you are feeling many emotions, but whether you will be continuing your studies or starting a new job, or using that degree to get yourself a promotion, I encourage you to view today not as an end, but a new beginning. So continue to work hard and be humble. Be respectful and kind and good to each other. Choose to believe that folks have good intentions, even when we don't agree. And in the face of adversity, always believe in yourself and know that you are valued and that you matter. As every graduation speech must conclude with a quote, I leave you with this from the book Antifragile by Nassim Taleb. Wind extinguishes a candle and energizes fire. In the years that lie ahead of you, there will be more wind. There will always be wind. But I hope you will choose to find and unleash that powerful fire inside of you and not succumb to the wind like the thin flame of a candle. To the graduating class of 2022, congratulations once again. And please know that you have made the CSCU system and the state of Connecticut very proud.
Hello, I'm Matt Fleury, Chair of the Board of Regents for Higher Education. On behalf of my fellow regents, it is my great honor to congratulate every member of the graduating class of 2022. Today is an opportunity to reflect and celebrate on the credential you worked so hard to earn and the incredible time and effort you put into getting to this point. It's also an opportunity to say thank you. Thank you to the faculty and the staff members who have gone above and beyond, especially over the past 2 years, to help you get to this point. All of us who have ever had the privilege to walk across a graduation stage know that it is thanks in no small part to the dedication of one or many educators who have taken the time to explain a particularly difficult concept or offer support during trying times. It makes all the difference, and we thank you. And to the family members, the friends, the support systems who've stood by your side throughout your educational journey, thank you. Your sacrifices are seen and they're appreciated. And this day is a celebration you have earned as well. To our graduates, your future is bright. Through a rigorous academic program, you've not only survived, you've grown as an individual. Whether your next step is continuing your education, entering the workforce, or something completely different, you should take it with the knowledge that you can do difficult things. After all, you are the future of Connecticut. So congratulations once again to the class of 2022. You have made all of us at the Board of Regents very, very proud.
Well, good afternoon, Capital Community College graduating class of 2022. Yes. As Dr. Harris mentioned, I am Dr. Rob Steinmetz, Capital East Regional President for Connecticut's Community College, and I am honored to say that Capital Community College is one of the colleges with which I work. On behalf of the entire region, I offer greetings and congratulations to the class of 2022. Your accomplishments are many, and each of you has a story of perseverance and dedication that you can reflect upon at this moment of celebration. That, perhaps more than anything, is what the completion of your degree represents: the ability to persevere, to delay gratification, to get back up when you've been knocked down. As you go forward and new challenges present themselves, you can come back to this moment as a reminder that you've met obstacles and that you have persevered. And you will be comforted with the knowledge that you will be equipped to do it again. As a community college graduate myself, I am so proud of your accomplishments and look forward to seeing the great things that you do next. I again offer my deep congratulations along with my encouragement that each of you continue in your academic and professional journeys while also paying it forward. You are deeply needed as an active participant of your communities. You will also shortly be a part of the large network of Capital Community College alumni, and I encourage you to support the students who come behind you with both your time and your treasure. Capital Community College graduating class of 2022, thank you for being the leaders of today and of the future. And remember that we are counting on you, and take this day to celebrate your well-deserved recognition. Thank you.
Thanks.
Institutions have the ability to award an honorary degree to an individual that has a strong connection to the college and that exemplifies the mission and spirit of the institution. This year's honorary degree will be presented by CSCU Regent Elise Wright.
It is my honor to present the 2022 Capital Community College Honorary Degree to Carmen Milagro Saez. Carmen unfortunately could not be here today in person. Carmen attended Capital Community College in the spring of 2001. She passed both her courses, but due to funding issues, did not continue with her educational goals. Since her time at Capital, she has been a volunteer advocate for many issues, including prison reform, gun reform, and mental health awareness. Recently, she has also expanded her advocacy work to helping children in the DCF system. She initially became interested in civil rights advocacy work when she was a fourth grade student at the Alfred E. Burr School in Hartford. She has used her own experiences with bipolar disorder and PTSD, as well as her sense of humor, to advocate. She has testified for over 50 bills being considered by the Judiciary Committee. In 2019, Carmen was honored with a certificate of appreciation from the Mayor's Office in Wethersfield, a proclamation from the City of Hartford, and an official citation from the State of Connecticut. She has also been featured in an exhibit titled Wethersfield Women, hosted by the Wethersfield Historical Society. Carmen's son, Joshua, is a second semester student at Capital. So, by virtue of the authority vested in me, the Connecticut Board of Regents for Higher Education concurring, I confer upon you the degree Associate of Science, Carmen Milagro Saez, honoris causa, and invest you with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereunto. Congratulations, Carmen.
Thank you.
Our faculty represent the heart of our institution, and our faculty have rallied over the past 26 months to ensure students were able to continue learning and pursuing their academic and career dreams. It is a part of Capital's rich commencement ritual that a faculty member bring greetings on behalf of our faculty. This year's remarks will be provided by Dr. Debbie Mather, Program Coordinator of the Medical Assisting Program and Department Chair for Allied Health and Career Programs.
Thank you and good afternoon. Dr. Harris, Connecticut Community College Regional President, Dr. Robert Steinmertz, Board of Regents member, Regent Elise Rice, CEO Compass Youth Collaborative, Jacqueline Santiago, members of the Platform Party, faculty, staff, and especially the graduates of the class of 2022. Capital Community College is a special destination and a hub of student life in the heart of Connecticut. I am privileged and honored today to come before you on behalf of the faculty of Capital Community College to congratulate you in earning your associate's degree or a certificate. Today is a beautiful day, not just because the sun is shining and the weather is finally warm, but because today is a day filled with pride. A day for you, our graduates, to hold your head up high after and reap the rewards after days of having your noses buried in your books. A day to thank family and friends of our graduates for supporting them in achieving their goals today. A day filled with pride for the faculty, because please know that each of you represent a feather in the hat of every professor that has ever left an impression with you or a pearl of wisdom or knowledge. We know that you have worked hard. You have sacrificed time away from your families, your friends, your sleep, to earn this honor today. You have the tenacity, resoluteness, and dedication to your education that is commendable and inspirational to us. Many of you have faced obstacles in your path, and you have not only overcome those obstacles, but you have also endured and overcame a surmountable task of learning during a global pandemic. But that did not stop you, because you are here today. We encourage you to challenge yourself, believe in yourself, and dream. And be ambitious in those dreams. Don't stop believing that you can achieve any goal you decide to go after. Keep your eyes and ears open for opportunity. Search and aspire for your best life, your happiness. Work for it, earn it. Be exhausted in a good way, a way you can be proud of. As educators, we remember what it was like to be in your shoes, although you might not think so. I teach the way I wish I was taught. It is that light bulb moment when you see that glimmer of excitement when you're learning that keeps us going as faculty. While we strive to deliver the best education possible, you have inadvertently humbled us with your personalities and your smiles. I always tell my students, smile with your voice and your eyes when communicating with the world, which is especially useful when we were wearing our masks. The joy of teaching at Capital is that you, the students, make us a community. Keep us with you as you soar high into your future. We are excited to know how you are doing and where your paths have taken you. Remember all the times that little voice inside you said, this is hard, but I can do it. And then today, on this beautiful day, let your voice say out loud, I did it. Because we, the faculty at Capital Community College, are proud of you. Congratulations to the graduates of the class of 2022.
College is tough. Can you imagine getting an A in every class you take? We had three students from this graduating class achieve this feat, and I'd like to recognize them at this point. And Regent Wright, David McCluskey, and President Steinmetz will present our highest award of achievement, of academic achievement, to these individuals. The individuals receiving this medallion are Megan Johnson, if she could come to the front. Megan. You got a round third. We're on a baseball stadium here. Mayan Nguyen. Mayan. And our third recipient, Erica Schultz Rendrella, our class valedictorian.
GoPro next time.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Awesome. Get a picture. Awesome. Okay. Yep. Awesome. Yep. Dr. Jason Scapaticci will now come to the podium to present our valedictorian and student achievement awards.
Thank you, Dr. Harris. Good afternoon, students, and congratulations. My name is Dr. Jason Scapaticci. I'm the Associate Dean of Student Affairs at Capital Community College, and it is my pleasure to introduce to you your transfer scholarship winners. So these students had to not only have a very specific GPA, but also had to make a significant contribution to their community, including their Capital community. Receiving the Dr. Arthur C. Banks Transfer Scholarship is Nana Kitofane and Fioni Wright. Would you please both stand to be recognized? You're just standing at your seats, students. Just want you to know. Congratulations to you. The Central Connecticut State University CEO to President Scholarship has gone to Grace Sanvliet. Congratulations, Grace. The Central Connecticut State University Merit Scholarship has been received by two students this year, Safira Jahaf and Kumlavi Sewonu. Congratulations. The Good Citizenship Award this year has been received by two students, Francis Gibson and Nahum Levitin. The Dr. J. E. Smith Scholarship has been received this year by Nahum Levitin. And I will just throw this in there, students. If you are graduating without having seen Nahum participate in a dance competition, you have missed a great show. Don't be shy, Nahum. You performed it right up there on that dugout. The University of Hartford CEO to President Scholarship has been received by Micah Johnson. And the Eastern Connecticut State University Capital Community College Scholarship has gone to Asia Blackwood. Congratulations to all of our transfer scholarship recipients. Will the valedictorian please join me at the podium? Students, it is my pleasure to introduce to you your class valedictorian, Erica Schultz Vendrella. Erica graduated, yes, absolutely applaud her. Erica graduated with an automotive certification from Emmett O'Brien Regional Vocational Technical High School and a culinary arts certification from Platt Tech in Milford. She obtained her library technical assistant certification from Capital Community College. And she is graduating now with a computer information systems degree. She has worked in public libraries for 18 years and become the cataloger and co-head of technical services at Derby Public Library. She was also voted by the employees to be the first president of the Acme Union for the library. She began working at Dr. William Finkelstein Health Sciences Library in St. Mary's Hospital. She was the lead librarian, as well as policy administrator, continuing medical education coordinator, and head of the staff experience team. Currently, she is working at the Dr. Daniel T. Banks Library in St. Vincent Medical Center, which is part of Hartford Healthcare. Her medical library experience has provided her with the opportunity to assist healthcare professionals through resource guidance, medical literature sources, while providing timely evidence-based information. Her additional responsibilities have allowed her to foster camaraderie among the staff that she works with. In her personal life, Erica is a devoted wife and mother. She has been married for over 35 years and has one daughter. She is a first-generation born citizen. Her father was born in the former Yugoslavia, in what is modern-day Slovenia. He immigrated to the United States after helping his father, Erica's grandfather, escape from a concentration camp. Her mother worked as an educator and is of Italian descent. Her grandfather, on her mother's side, became an electrician at a very young age during a time when it was extremely difficult for Italian immigrants to earn such credentials. I introduce to you your valedictorian.
Thank you. Congratulations. We made it. We graduated. First, I'd like to thank the professors, adjuncts, administration, and the entire staff at Capital Community College for their instructional guidance, patience, and kindness. A special thank you to Dr. LaPierre Dreger, Professor Seth Freeman, Michael Legion, Karen Deloach, and Professor Susie. I would also like to thank Kathy Wilson, Roxana Plummer, and Angelio Morello. I would also like to thank all the friends and partners and family members who supported us through our journey. Secondly, I would like to say that I am proud to be part of this class, and I know the friendships and connections I've made here are valuable. Each one of us is intrinsically unique. We each have our own gifts, talents, and abilities. We see things from our own perspectives. We created these perspectives based on our experiences, values, and the knowledge that we have gained. And yet, we are all the same in so many ways. We worked hard to experience this moment. We studied, researched, critiqued so much information, all to be able to be here at our graduation. We should be proud of ourselves. We made it. There are moments in our lives, such as this, that we would like to remember for a lifetime. These pieces of time are impactful and crucial. One of these moments occurred for me when I went to pick up my cap and gown. I walked into the bookstore, looked around. Everyone was so happy. The sense of excitement from everybody in the room was contagious. I saw so many beautiful, smiling faces, because I don't care who you are or what you look like. To me, you're beautiful when you smile. Wouldn't it be wonderful if we could maintain that sense of camaraderie every day of our lives? I believe we can make this a better world by learning from the past, sustaining our fellowship, and staying open-minded. I recently heard a quote that I would like to share with all of you. When the facts change, I change my mind. What do you do? This quote was attributed to John Maynard Keynes. However, it appears he was not the first person to coin this phrase, as this statement was attributed to Paul Samson and Winston Churchill. Although the statement was altered multiple times, the premise stays the same. If we open our hearts and our minds to grasp concepts we never thought were possible, we can create a better world. Lastly, I'd like to suggest everyone
please find peace. Don't compromise your values. Keep your faith. Be altruistic. Let your conscience guide you. Ask yourself, if I do this, what could happen? Try to see the bigger picture. If nothing else, love unconditionally. As some of my classmates know, I've read many near-death experiences, and there appears to be one continuous resounding message: love. Love everyone and judge no one. If we look for the good, we will see the good. We just need to keep an open mind. If we can do this, and I know that we can, I have faith that we will make a world of difference. Thank you, class of 2022.
All right.
Our keynote speaker for the occasion is Jacqueline Santiago. Yeah, that's good. All right. Jacqueline Santiago is the Chief Executive Officer of Campus Youth Collaborative, an organization that provides after-school programs, comprehensive day school supports, and outreach and crisis intervention programs for youth at risk. A quote that she shared that gives us a sense of her purpose is, "Youth are my inspiration, and my deepest desire is to see them thrive in our communities." Ladies and gentlemen, the speaker of the hour, Jacqueline Santiago.
I am so honored to be here today with the graduates of Capital Community College, class of 2022. That's right. Congratulations to all of you who worked so hard for this day. For the families in the audience, congratulations to you too. Your support, no doubt, brought the graduates to this beautiful day. You know, when Dr. Harris asked me to speak, I instantly got butterflies, nauseous, shaky. I was tempted to say no. I told myself that this was too big of a stage, wondered why, of all people, he chose me, then pictured myself tripping on my words and falling flat on my face. Then I remembered that few graduates ever remember their graduation speakers, and I thought, how much harm could I possibly do? While I'm mostly joking and exaggerating about my fear of public speaking, I cannot joke about the fact we desperately need young leaders to use their education to change the world for the better. In my line of work, I see youth die without hope, without resources, without seeing or experiencing life. So it's my duty to speak to future leaders about how the educational journey changed my life forever and gave me the tools I needed to give voice to the hopeless. Let me introduce you to Alejandro. I changed the name to protect his identity, but years ago, Alejandro became a Latino crew member at age 16. He had a nervous energy and could never stay still for too long. At first glance, he was unapproachable. His hardened face had scars from the many fights in his neighborhood. He barely spoke, and when he did, it was slang and swear words. His dark brown eyes did not sparkle. They did not betray any secrets of the streets or his home. His cold eyes communicated that he did not trust a soul. Everything I learned about him was through observation, case notes, and police reports. He never felt safe, and he felt like he needed to protect himself from a young age because his father was killed at 8 years old. He was attacked with a knife in the stairwell of his apartment. And that was the start of his mom's career in drug dealing and prostitution. He was the man of the house even when they no longer had a home. Once mom was jailed, he was homeless and selling drugs to survive. His life was spiraling out of control. While in my own life, I battled with poverty, parents' alcoholism, and domestic abuse. There were many differences in our story, but the biggest one is that education literally saved my life. I am now the CEO of a nonprofit in Hartford, Connecticut, Compass Youth Collaborative. We dedicate our lives to ensuring that youth like Alejandro can learn how to deal with trauma in a healthy way. We make sure they're connected to school, that they learn work skills, manage their emotions, and most importantly, that they remain violence-free. I wake up every day thinking that being a CEO is a dream. But the only reason why I know it's not is because I never dreamed of being a CEO. I never knew another brown Latina CEO in my community. In our neighborhoods, we had our given professions. We were custodians, cooks, and secretaries. When my parents spoke of an education, they told me I should get it so I can have a nice secretary job helping people. There is nothing wrong with that, and we need those jobs. But there is something wrong with the fact that my dad never dared to dream. He was denied opportunities, and his good Puerto Rican traditions and values were mocked and abused. So he would always just tell me, be grateful for what you have and don't aspire too high. Stick to what you know and do it well. This thinking was more embedded inside of my brain than I had thought. I began to think that I was not good enough. I began to think that I needed a talent from birth to be successful, or else it just was not meant to be. I should be thankful to God for the things that I had. After all, there were kids that had much less than I did. Without noticing, I never ventured to try new or challenging things. I would only do those things I knew that I could excel at. Failure was not an option. Secretly, I thought that failure would mean that I was good at nothing and I would be worthless. Thankfully, I loved learning, had a natural curiosity, and asked a million questions, still do, and I was a good student. So I got lucky and received scholarships to attend private schools that changed the trajectory of my life forever. And I found that no one looked like me. I was the only brown-skinned girl with coarse hair and a broad nose. I had a Spanish accent. Every once in a while, people could tell I was Puerto Rican because the word chair would become share. And there were times where I would say, Mira, you don't know who you're messing with. I had a tiny little bit of inner city attitude. So don't look at me the wrong way or I could be in your face in a hot second. That attitude busted through every time I felt threatened with comments about how poor I looked, how funny I spoke, or how weird looking I was. I wanted to quit every single day, but my mom told me that I needed to stick to it. I was walking the same path in my $5 shoes that they were walking in their $100 shoes. I did not want to disappoint my parents, so I continued learning at the private school and I immersed myself into the books. Funny enough, through reading, I learned about my roots, the things that my father's fifth grade education could not teach me. And I realized for the first time that my brown skin was due to my African heritage. As a Puerto Rican, I was never taught this important piece of information. I was Puerto Rican and proud, but had not been taught that my ancestors came from Africa. This was important because I learned to love a different part of me. I learned to find the ties that connect people. I learned to talk to different people and collaborate with them. I learned to create common understandings amongst different groups of people, and at the end of 4 years, I could work with people who were completely different from me. This was truly important because I spent my daytime hours in an affluent school and nighttime hours in the housing projects of Lawrence, Massachusetts. I was becoming a different person. The more I learned from school and my journey to understand people, the more I didn't belong in either world. I was ashamed of this for a long time until I realized it was an amazing gift. I had been given the opportunity to experience wealth, privilege, and education. My eyes were opened and I had the ability to dream of other possibilities. I was able to stop and reflect on how they might see a situation differently from me based on how they lived. I learned to stop being angry and communicate my point with professionalism and grace. My love for learning led me to Trinity College. I continued my journey into affluence, yet I was determined to connect with the pieces of me that were outside of the Trinity gates. I needed to immerse myself in the Hartford community because I felt an overwhelming sense of guilt that I was able to pursue a higher education only a street away from incredible poverty. Poverty that I had lived in Lawrence. As soon as I was able to, I started an internship at Hart as a community organizer, and I helped recruit the first Learning Corridor class right outside of the Trinity gates. I also worked with the Hartford Jobs Funnel, providing training and employment opportunities to people who would otherwise be overlooked. I felt so good. It felt right to provide opportunities and resources to young people through education and employment. If given the right resources, opportunities, and mentors, I knew that they could flourish. Through my experiences, I realized that I was lucky to have an opportunity to get some of the best education in the country. If other people could receive the same resources I had, what could their success be? I still ask myself that question. I am still on a journey to ensure that every youth has the right resources and opportunities when they need them. I believe that any youth given the right tools and resources can flourish. I'm not the exception, but the rule. I have experienced how providing job training, necessary equipment, and mentorship resulted in a career at a power plant. I have experienced a dropout immersed in a lifestyle of violence and drugs become an A student. Through my career, I have witnessed how a person with a prior felony conviction can be the testimony and support that saves a young life. The person who guides the youth from a life of crime to a life full of hope for the future. In graduate school, I learned how to lead an agency to success. What I really learned was to strategize, plan, collaborate, and negotiate. I use these skills when doing systems work. I realized that the best way to bring positive change for youth is to influence policy. So even though I'm an introvert who prefers to be in the background, I became emboldened by the degree, but more so by the knowledge gained, by the sense of duty to help others like Alejandro. I hope this degree emboldens all of you graduates. You are about to have a resource, an opportunity, a journey that others have not been able to unlock. To whom much is given, much is expected. You now have a duty to give back. We still have so many issues to solve. We live in America, yet there are people who are hungry, face daily violence in their neighborhoods and schools, lack quality education, lack jobs paying a living wage, and our youth need mentorship more than ever. I ask, what will you do about it? I know that you have earned your degree despite all of the obstacles that you have faced. I know your life responsibilities made it much harder to be a good student. Taking care of your family, yeah, even that annoying little brother, or maybe it was grandma or titi that tells you the truth whether you want to hear it or not, saying things like, "Nena, school made you fat," but you preserved You persevered despite your financial struggle that made you work more than one job while going to school. Perhaps like me, you had family members struggling with drug addiction or the overwhelming stress of raising kids and the feelings of maybe I'm not good enough. I ask you to tap into all of those feelings, to all of those hurdles, and have the feelings of that struggle again so that you could use it to be a voice for those who do not have a degree, the one that you now possess. Education was truly my path out of poverty of the mind and the wallet, but it was not just the academic rigor, but the lessons learned through my environment, the connections with people and their perspectives, and challenging myself to rise above the fear and the doubt that I'm not enough. I invite you to learn on some of the lessons I learned through my educational journey. One, do not be afraid to dream. In fact, dream knowing that there are many good opportunities to fail. Being realistic about the obstacles you face will actually help you achieve your dream. It is our false sense that our stories should be a fairy tale with platinum paths, Lamborghinis, laughter, lots of bling, and throw in a fairy godmother. But in reality, when we plan for obstacles, we are prepared to adjust the plan as necessary. It is problematic when we dream about our fairy tale with no troubles or challenges. Our brain tricks us into believing that we're not built for it, not good enough, and we quit. Failures are designed to be our greatest teacher, and if only if you are humble enough to receive them. Change your perspective. Learn to embrace even those who have opposing viewpoints. Listen to their experience and why they feel like they do. Ask questions, but don't judge. You may learn something that you did not know before. You may learn how to strategize against this viewpoint in the future, or perhaps there's a way to meet in the middle. We do not know it all. Sometimes we need to compromise to make the most difference. And three, use your voice to represent in the rooms where decisions are made. Like Lin-Manuel Miranda says, make your way to the room where it happens. And I'll add, then speak for people like you and me. We have been closest to the problem. We know from experience what can work and what does not work. We know what humane solutions are possible, but are often left out of the decision making. Tap into the harsh experience of yours to make a difference for others. Graduates, you now have a new tool, and you are whom we need to make a difference. I know that our challenges and obstacles have built the character muscles, the persistent muscles, and that grit muscle, and we realize that we have the strength to make changes in our own lives and for others' lives. Now is your opportunity to make a difference. As I close, I will leave you to remember Winston Churchill's words. We make a living by what we get, and we make a life by what we give. I cannot wait to see what you, Capital Community College graduates, give to the world. Congratulations, class of 2022!
All right, at this point, the moment you've all been waiting for. Can we hear it? Let's hear it. You guys ready? All right. That was all the warm-up act. Dr. Scappaticci, please ready our candidates.
Dr. Harris and distinguished guests, I, Dr. Scappaticci, and pleased to present the members of the class of 2022. These candidates have met the academic requirements for associate degree and certificate programs as established by the Board of Regents for Higher Education. Will the certificate candidates please rise? The names of the candidates for certificates will be read by Dr. Andre Freeman, Professor of Mathematics. Going to hand them to you. Ooh. We're ready. Dr. Freeman.
Rachel M. Cruz. Saeed Mohammed Tariq Husseini. And Laurel. Yeah. Laurel Ann Mandu. Mercedes Jasmine Marie Royce.
Will candidates for the Associate in Science degree in General Studies please rise? The candidate names for General Study degrees will be read by Dr. Daniela Ragusa, Humanities Department Chair.
Teresa Walczewski. Christine Frances Cupe Baker.
Rainisha Ashara Dawkins.
Rainisha Ashara Dawkins. Malaika Alima Fonlins. Sheila J. Green. Nayaris Guadalupe. Michelle Jackson. Caleb Spring Natupsky. Loretta Terry Prempe. Jalissa Marie Stavola. Grace A. Stanfleet. Rukeya Tu Amado. Jasmine Yolanda Almodovar. Rachel M. Cruz. Morgan Tyler Wiggins.
Will the candidates for associate degrees from the Department of Business and Technology please rise? The candidate names for business and technology degrees will be read by Professor Gerald Murphy, Business and Technology Department Chair.
Welcome, everybody, and salam alaikum to my fellow Muslim brothers and sisters. Mercedes Jasmine Marie Roy. Sadia Awini Lomo. Nizamuddin Bacchus. Anessa Chekik. Akasua Darko. Yeslit Eliza Diaz Gonzalez. Paula Denise Easterling. Merlin Flores Miranda. Jeremy Patrick Gamble. Fiona Gale. Jovan Grant. Kevin Hale. Margarita Hardy. Evan Holmes. Safira Yahya Jahaf. Andrew Kiptu. Andre Lewis. Mian Nguyen. Juliana Opoku. Diana Osorio. T. Kiri Daniela Pena. Annabelle Pericha. Congratulations. Jesslyn Ramos. Willerson Ribeiro. Sean Sabino. Grace Sandvliet. Marjorie Santana. Kumlavi Sewonu. Kyle Szymanskis. Jasmine Taylor. Last but not least, Erica Schultz-Vendrea. On behalf of my colleagues in the Business and Technology Department, I would like to congratulate all of the graduates. Thank you.
Will candidates for the associate degrees from the Department of Health Careers and Public Safety please rise? The candidate names for Health Careers and Public Safety will be read by Dr. Devi Mathur, Health Careers and Public Safety Department Chair.
Kamoya Abigail Charles. Donna Del Donna. Yulissa Figuero. Lena D. Wright. Tyreek Tyrone Green. Megan Elizabeth Johnson. Shariah LaDonna Smith. Colleen Ronica Young Bear. Maya Lee Yurko. Congratulations to all the graduates on behalf of the Department of Health Careers.
Will candidates for the associate degrees from the Department of Humanities please rise? The candidate names for Humanities will be read by Dr. Daniela Ragusa, Humanities Department Chair.
Dravon Q. Birdsong. Joshua Lawrence Doherty. Avik Cordell James. Jessica Tanea Johnson. Michael Henry Johnson. Jessica L. Jones. Sabrina Lemieux. Nakam Hirsch Levitin. Edward Jr. Martinez. Ashley Lynn Sanchez. Mojisola Spencer. Cleveland Anthony Morgan. On behalf of Humanities, congratulations to all the graduates.
Oh, this way, Cleveland. Oh, okay. Will candidates for the associate degree from the Department of Nursing please rise? The candidate names for nursing will be read by Dr. Dawn Bunting, Nursing Department Chair.
Here we go. Maria Abad Delgado. Martha Lois A. Addo.
Cindy Lakshmi Algu.
Rodaline Na Korkor Apia Kubi. Brianna Berry. Angela Lorraine Barsh. Rochelle Belwa. Angela Angie Bello. Lady Lynn D. Bermudez. Melissa Burney. Sapotka? Sapotka? Sita Busal Sapotka. You're welcome.
Do you need it?
Martinisha L. Brown.
Sally Shaquante Brown. Micaiah Alexis Caldwell. Rayando Campbell. Jason Cass. Sarah Ashley Coburn. Sanaja Cooley. Angela Marie Collins. Rosa Ivalice Colon. Irene Rebecca Kakuda. Ricky Davidson.
It's Jackie.
Jackie, I know I said it. Jackie Lynn Davis. Mallory Nicole DeJesus.
Salavi, right?
Salavi Amy Diaz. Winsome Angela Dobson. Morliana Evans. Nicole Marie Everett. Ebony Venice Floyd. Michaela Gardner. Tawanda Denise Gaston. Frances Lily Anna Gibson. Trisha Laney Guest. Nicole Gonzalez. Thomas John Gonzalez. Brianna Marie Gaudier.
Islet.
Islet. Venetia Islet Green.
I met your mom.
Oh, can I say his name?
Yeah.
Daniel and Sebastian Hammersmith.
Uchenna
Rosemary Eichem. Marta Janer Robinson. Holly Blythe Johnson. Yeah? Okay. Karina Juarez Zimmerman. Benjamin Robert Keys. Omar Johnny Khan. Serena Ann Kimball.
Congratulations.
Nana Mayuli Kittipan. Sarah Ann Noblock. Marissa Kujansik. Yasmin Karuka. Christine LaJoy. Christendale Pito Leis. Heather Marie Lemaire. Kareem Lazardi. Congratulations. Julie Loomis. Is it Nasian or Nasian?
Nasian.
Nasian Melanie Lynn. Get a dry mouth. Alyssa Claire Maylap. Aldo Roel Mentella. Stephanie Elizabeth Mata. Alicia N. McDonald. Pamela Ann McGeechee. Albiona Mersini. Emily Messias Moya. Carmen Minga. Giaconda Matera. Asalama Mohammed. Cynthia Namaswa. Maria Nakai. Angelica Nimaltsava. Gary Jr. Noel. Ngozi Abiocha. Panty. Sajana Panty.
They didn't say my husband's name.
Okay. Kai Nigeri Peak Clark. Wisleen Pettit Home. Amy Porter.
Thank you.
Isabella Christina Prezeres. Jessica Mary Prince. Tatiana Protsanen. Jessica Lynn Putnam. Lauren Michelle Ritchie. Aaron Rigono. Glenn C. Riley. Shanale Yvette Roman. Shaneska Santiago. Claudia Christina Santos. Julia Sayasith. Tiffany Serrano.
Samra.
Sean.
Yep.
Samra. Samra R. Sean. Stephanie Lauren Shepherd. Congratulations. Christine Marie Sylvia. Alexis Lachey Singh. Vanessa Ava Gay Stewart.
Mine is easy.
Natalia Stopka. Kimberly Michelle Sula. Sebastian Christian Tiber. Rosie Vaquito Baez. Jason R. Wagert. Siobhan Alexis Webb. Kylie Wiles. Lisa Gay Chanel Williams.
Say it again. Yavdashniak.
Oksana Yavdashniak. Audrey Saporta. On behalf of myself, nursing faculty, and staff, congratulations, nurses.
Thank you, Dr. Bunting. And thank you, Dr. Bunting, for your 45 years as a nurse and your 25 years at Capital. Will the candidates for an associate degree from the Department of Science and Mathematics please rise? The candidate names for science and mathematics will be read by Dr. Andre Freeman, Professor of Mathematics.
Rachel Lachey Gary. Carissa Menez. On behalf of Science and Mathematics, congratulations to all the graduates.
Will candidates for associate degrees from the Department of Social and Behavioral Sciences please rise? The candidate names for Social and Behavioral Sciences will be read by Dr. Josiah Ricardo, Professor of Sociology and Program Coordinator for Social Services.
Dr. Harris, we are graduating criminal justice majors who will make our community safer, future social workers who will combat social injustice, and amazing teachers, and also those who will inform facts through their communication majors. There we go. Silkia Bonilla. Shanoi Chris Ann Campbell. Jill Lee Anna Cruzet. Brittany Andrea Davis. Yaritza De Jesus. Axel Manuel Diaz. Alexis Andrea Dudley. Yeah. Brianna Galindez. Latanya Genis. Brianna Givens. Joanna Elizabeth Miller. Kashina Patrice Miller. Nancy Morales Herrera. And by special request, Professor Jerry Murphy, please announce the next candidate.
I don't need this tag. I'm happy to congratulate my wife, Lulu Sadala Murphy.
Peter Gail Noble. Randy Regine Parkman. Nicolette Annette Reed Brown.
Love you.
Jacqueline Lucille Richardson. Mayra Luz Rios. Marcos Daniel Rodriguez. Yeah. Miriam Serrano. Joanna Torres. Shailina Eusebia Velez. Carol Antoinette White. Brittany Leisha Anderson.
Congratulations.
Paul White. Dr. Harris, this concludes the name of the students who are majoring in the social and behavioral sciences. On behalf of our department, we love our students. Thank you.
Home stretch. So we're rounding third. I, like many, was diagnosed and significantly impacted by COVID in the March of 2020. This experience impacted my approach to the care and custody and my leadership, of this institution over the past 26 months. I have also developed a deeper appreciation for our faculty and staff that have committed their lives to the preparation of professionals that work in nursing, medical assisting, EMS, radiological technology, and related fields, and salute them and our students graduating today that have selected fields that preserve and safeguard human life. Capital alumni have been at the front lines saving lives since the start of the pandemic, and it's a part of who we are and what we do in this region, and I salute you all today. I know that I'm the only thing between you and a celebration with family and friends, so I'll be brief and leave you with two items. My favorite quote, which is fitting for this occasion, which is, and I quote, "Education is an ornament in times of prosperity and a shield in times of adversity." This is especially apropos today. We're coming out of a period of social distancing from friends and family, and a significant loss in the upending of lives. I hope your capital degree and what you've learned will be able to be both a shield and a source of pride, as reflected by today's ornate celebration of your accomplishment. Second, I have a favor to ask. I'm going to ask that you commit to something. I'm going to ask you to stay connected with your alma mater and give back. Many of you will go on to get other degrees from other institutions. Don't forget your capital days. Our foundation has spent the last year revamping its operations and working on ways to make it easy for you to stay connected and invest in those capital students that will come after you. You know the difference we make, and we'll be asking you to help us do it for others. As I close, I'd encourage you to remember fondly the hours spent riding one of our five elevators between floors. Remember hanging out on the seventh floor. Remember your first play at Hartford Stage. Don't forget about the time one of our counselors, advisors, or mentors, Helena Carrasquillo, Roxanne Plummer, or Ashley Coleman, was there for you when you were having a rough day. Or when Randall Ward made sure you had something to eat from our pantry. Or one of our campus safety police officers, Joel, Steve, Jesus, Carmen, or Scotty, checked on you to see how your day was going when you were coming or leaving the building. Remember that passion for architecture ignited by Professor Ira Hesmer, for writing by Professor Lampkins, for biology by Professor Cleo Roll, or for nursing by Dr. Dawn Bunting. This is Dr. Bunting's last Capital graduation. She has served here since 1997 as both a faculty member and director of our nursing department, and we honor the difference you have made. Students, I truly hope you remember your time spent at Capital fondly, and when you drive by our building, you smile and reflect positively on your accomplishment and your time at Capital. Capital Community College Class of 2022, please stand. By the virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Regents, I herewith confer upon you corresponding certificate, Associate in Arts, Associates in Science, and Associate in Applied Science degrees, and thereby admit to you the rights, privileges, and responsibilities hereto appertaining. Congratulations and best wishes to those who have received degrees and certificates from Capital Community College today. You are now Capital College Community College graduates and alumni. Would the audience please join me in a round of applause for all of our graduates who may now turn their tassels from the left to the left, signifying graduation. Following the benediction by Reverend Terry Cummings, we have a special and fitting treat as a part of our tradition here at CCC. The drum has had significant meaning in cultures for centuries. At Capitol, we honor this meaning and tradition at the end of our commencement ceremony. We will be led out of the hall by one of the state's best drumming corps, the Hartford Proud Drill, Drum, and Dance Corp, led by Terry and Duffy Sparks. Would the assembled please rise for the benediction by Reverend Cummings. The Capitol Community College 75th commencement exercises are now complete.
The word benediction comes from two Latin words, bene, meaning good, dicta, meaning word. Benediction means the good word. And I ask you to join with me now in a benediction prayer. Great and Holy Spirit, God of compassion and mercy, with their classes and grading now complete, with the applause quieted, almost, with the speeches concluded, in gratitude and in joy, we pray. We pray that the voices of this graduating class will rise up to pronounce peace and justice in the world. May they find success in their future endeavors. May their challenges be few. May their achievements be many and growing. In the days, months, and years ahead, may they have the grace and wisdom to make wise choices, to stay faithful to their commitments, confident in the support of those who love them. God, may they have the foolishness to think that they can make a difference in the world, so they will do things that others tell them cannot be done. Bless their lives from this day on with goodness and grace. We understand, Holy One, that as their lives move on into a new chapter, there will be more challenges to face and more will be demanded of them. God, give them patience and hope to energize their search for work that is just and makes proper use of their gifts. Holy Spirit, give them courage to face the challenges of carving out a world where we might all live in peace, service, and gratitude. Above all, Holy One, may they give, receive, and do love, for in love there is life. Blessed be, may it be so. Ashe, amen, and congratulations from this minister. Thank you.
Graduates, please remain standing. We will process out now to the drum corps. Your administration and faculty will process out first, and then you graduates. Congratulations.